everyone, welcome back to the Fruity Master channel. And today we're going to do how to make hardstyle
with the D-Tunes. Hello. Yeah, hello everyone, welcome back. This is Fruity Master channel, and today we're here with D-Tunes, and we are going to continue with our how to make hardstyle project. This is the fourth video, and there are going to be lots more. And today we might do some kick rolls, perhaps, and a build up. You already know because it's in the title, but we don't. So for us, it's more like a surprise. So let's go. D-Tunes is in the producer chair right now, so it's him doing all the stuff. But in case he doesn't really talk that much or that happy, I'm going to ask him some questions. So D-Tunes, go ahead. Screw up my project file.
Yeah, I always do that.
No, seriously, he's pretty damn good at track build-ups and stuff.
Well, first let's hear what we have got right now. Do you think that's a good idea?
Yeah, nice. Just press the stop button over there.
Or just do this.
This is how it's going to be the entire episode. Let's go.
So yeah, that's what we have now.
So what are we going to do now?
Always, when I have a melody, I'm going to start with the drop. Well, the kicks are in here, so I don't need to worry about that. Let's just put in some samples. I copied my sample shit from...
So as I understand, this is the D-Tunes sample pack?
Yes.
Nice. It's not available for download.
But I'm not going to use it right now. I'm just going to use the normal crash. And I'm gonna edit it.
Oh, nice.
So now it sounds like
this. With a delay.
And it sounds like shit. So we're gonna double click. We're gonna press track. What that does is it's going to put it to a new mixer track.
I usually use Ctrl L.
So we're gonna EQ it a little bit. And let's solo it for now. One other helpful thing. If you click this arrow right here, and you click detached, you can click everywhere, but the window won't disappear. And I don't know if you knew that.
Oh, that's a nice one.
You didn't knew it.
I didn't. 12 years of FL Studio.
You always learn something from me.
Yep.
Just like the stereo separation. And
damn.
Yeah. Most of other things. But okay, let's listen to the crash. Now you see, here's a little bit of low rumbling shit.
Hey, D-Tunes, I got FabFilter. Please.
Yeah, I don't use FabFilter, so...
Okay, for this episode, we are going to use the Fruity Parametric EQ, which is nice.
Two.
Because, two, of course.
EQ.
One is also nice. It's a bit more analog looking.
It's shit.
But,
It's shit.
No, it's not. Yeah, for those who don't have FabFilter, now I'm sort of an asshole showing up with Kontakt and FabFilter and all those stuff you guys might not have. This really is in every FL Studio. You can simply grab Fruity Parametric EQ right now. So that's nice. Let's go.
So we're going to click this little...
That's the shape of the EQ you are going to make.
Yes. So we're going to drag it down once, twice. So it has a big low cut. And this little point...
We'll make it sharper.
We're going to put it all the way down so it makes it sharper.
Yes.
So now we're just going to drag it to the frequencies we don't want.
I must say, I basically never EQ a crash, but nice.
And we're gonna take away some highs.
Oh, that's actually pretty nice.
I know. So it won't hurt your ears when you're playing on loud volume. Now, one other thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some reverb to it.
Fruity Reverb is a really nice one. You can use Valhalla or anything else, but Fruity Reverb 1. It's unique to FL Studio, of course, but it's a pretty damn nice reverb.
Yeah, I always use it. So
I prefer it over Fruity Reverb 2. I don't know why, but somehow it sounds and works better for me. How about you?
Well, I only use Fruity Reverb 2 with kicks, you know? When you have a kick at the end of the climax, you know? And you
to make it more bigger or something.
Yeah. Just okay. Boom in plaats van, instead of the boom.
Nice.
You know?
Yeah, we, yeah, I know. Rawr, bam. Something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, something like that. So, I'm just going to put the low cut up. To, I don't know, somewhere around here. High cut all the way, no, not all the way up. Till 10, I guess.
Yeah, the high cut and the low cut are basically EQs. Yeah, the same thing that happened in the parametric EQ too, over there on the right. You can make high cuts, you can remove high frequencies and low frequencies on the reverb itself.
So basically, the only reverb you hear is between 256 hertz and 10.8 kilohertz. So I'm gonna put the room size up, the color to warm.
So why are you putting the room size up?
Because it sounds nice.
Okay.
Nah, it
doesn't sound metallic. Not like metal, but...
It doesn't sound like a can.
Yeah, Kenny. Candy. Okay, nice.
I'm gonna put the high damping a bit up. The DK.
So the high dampening is also sort of an EQ, I guess.
So maybe a bit more.
Yeah, you can pretty much push the DK a little bit on the crash. Perhaps 5, 6, 7, or 8 seconds.
Don't do it too long, because
20 seconds. Or you could also put a compression after the reverb, which basically pulls up the reverb a little bit after the crash. Well, basically, it pulls down the volume of the crash and not the volume of the reverb. But after that, you do some gain compensation, which pulls up the reverb.
So now we have this. So a comparison. This was it before. This is it now.
That's actually a nice crash.
Thank you. We're gonna de-detach it. Or attach it. Or I don't know.
Attach.
Yeah. That. All right. So that sounds okay. Right?
It sounds nice, but perhaps with some sort of pre-sweep or something. Like... Whoosh, bam, ta, 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 ta.
That will come later.
Okay. I trust in you, D-Tunes.
That's for the first time.
Okay, over to you.
All right, we're gonna put some white noise now.
Nice.
And I'm not gonna use a sample for that. I'm going to use Silent One for that.
That's interesting.
That's the very first time I'm ever gonna do that.
This is some useful stuff, guys. We are going to make something from scratch. No, from noise, basically.
Just select the noise waveform here. That's what you get.
Yeah, it sounds boring, and most of you guys might not know you can do many stuff with this noise.
So we're gonna put this to a new mix track again. And get your parametric EQ 2 again. And remove the low ends. Like that.
Just as a reminder, I'm going to use Fab Filter the next time. Please continue.
And we're gonna put a filter after this. So a fruity nice filter.
That's basically an automated EQ.
Yes.
So you could do this with the same parametric EQ by creating an automation clip on one of the parameters of the EQ.
But this is easier.
Okay. Okay, so starting to sound like an effect.
So that's pretty much what's going to happen. So we're going to make a note.
Okay, you continue. I'm going to grab something to smoke.
Again.
Yes.
He said he only would smoke one today. But yeah. So it sounds like this now. So we're going to automate that. So right click, create automation clip. Oh, it's doing it for the whole project now. That's not what you want. So we're going to delete it. We're going to select the part where we want the automation to happen. And we're going to create an automation clip again. So let me put the volume down too, like this.
So I'm back.
Yeah, that's pretty much what we're going to do. Maybe a bit of side chaining. So we're going to use Kickstart for that.
Yeah, but the thing about Kickstart, when you add it on a sort of exhaust sound, this is basically an exhaust you're making, the punch sort of disappears, but the crash is also on top, right?
Yes.
So the crash basically replaces the punch.
Yeah, that's
nice. Right.
So, since we are not having... Oh, we actually do have a triplet melody. That's interesting.
Nice.
That may be tricky then.
What?
Maybe like this. I'm just going to match it. Let's not do Kickstart.
Nah, it might be nice. It's on the beat. What about the delay on the clap? Clap crash.
A delay?
Yeah.
That's also a pretty interesting idea.
Something like that really awesome native instruments. Just click the preset. Okay. Replica XT. Something you guys also don't have.
Yeah, but what you do have is Fruity Delay 2.
Ah, damn. How about Fruity Delay 3?
I have never used that. So, okay. I'll just stick with 2 because
so
it works fine.
I'm interested in this one because I don't use Fruity Delay 2 a lot. I know it's a nice one, but I don't know a lot about using it. So, please show us.
Okay, well, first we're going to do is we're going to put the time to 4. Because then you have a nice rhythm in the crash.
Yeah, on-beat rhythm. Ah, nice, nice, nice.
Exactly. Now, I want it to be delayed a bit longer. So I'm going
increase
to put
the decay.
So I'm going to put the feedback level up.
And how about making it go from the left to the right a little bit more?
Yeah, that's pretty easy. You just go to ping pong.
Nice.
And then put it to the left or the right, doesn't really matter. And then you have this.
Oh, nice. I didn't know that. Oh, crap. So you use the pen and it goes from the left to the right. But what if you use the ping pong and you don't use the pen?
Then it's doing nothing.
Ah.
So just use the pen then, because otherwise it would be weird.
Okay,
to
nice.
Put it to ping pong. But oh. I'm going to put the input volume a bit lower.
Yeah, you can hear it now, but once it's in the track, it might be really low volume, perhaps a little bit more extreme.
But the things you don't hear that much do fill up the mix.
That's true. Sometimes you only know how important something is once it's missing.
When you leave it out.
Yeah. So yeah. When you kill your cat, you might miss the cat. But when you don't, you might still hate it. Let's continue.
Yeah, Fruity Logic.
Yeah, I didn't really hear the delay.
You didn't? I did.
Okay, try it again. Yeah, sort of, but not really. Do some more presence.
Yeah?
In my opinion, yeah. The fruity guy likes extreme stuff.
Okay, so we maybe layer this sweep with other sweeps. So, yeah, I'm going to use samples for that because it's easier. I'm lazy, you know, so sweep down.
Now, here's a funny thing. He says he's lazy, but his project files are sort of more complex than mine. Yeah.
But I'm still lazy.
Yeah, so he's lazy in a very nice way.
Drag it in. Put it into a new mixer track.
By the way, if you don't know where to find the Kashmir samples, you can get them on splice.com. Also with some other very nice stuff. Splice.com is really awesome. I'm really not sponsored by them, but for those who are interested and don't know where to find it, that's the place. They also have some cool mixdowns on tracks, on official tracks, by well-known artists, producers, DJs. Yeah, I learned a lot from them, perhaps you too. Like the drop from Chesto with Kashmir on Secrets, it's also on Splice. And it's really interesting to look at those mixer tracks. So, yeah. Perhaps you guys might like that. Now, let's continue.
I think this is going to be a long episode. I'm missing something in the lead. So I think I'm going to add another layer. With some chords.
So that's chords in Dutch.
No, it's not. So open silent one. And I'm going to put a super saw. 8 voices. So it sounds a bit bigger.
Now this might be interesting because the D-Tune's way of making chords is a little different than mine. But yeah, it's different. Not better or worse. Yeah, so might be interesting.
I'm kind of doing it the piano way.
He's doing it the official way, using scales.
Yeah. So I'm going to put 4x8 voices. And all saws. So I'm going to put the detune up. Detunes.
Detune. We basically have 4 detunes here.
Just like this a bit. Maybe put one an octave down. Put the polyphony up to 16 or whatever.
Polyphony.
Polyphony, I don't care. So
my little polyphony.
So if you put this to polyphony. If you put this to 0 and you press a key, nothing will happen because it won't play a note because it's on 0. If you put it on 1, you can play only 1 note at the time. If you put it to 3, you can play up to 3 notes at the time. And if you put it to 16, you can play up to 60 notes at the same time.
So basically, it will be really hard to play 70 notes at the same time in Silent One. But that's also not necessary, because you can use the B part to go 1 octave up.
Yeah. I don't really see the reason why you should want 17 notes. Altogether. But okay. Since we have a little bit of pitching up at the beginning of the note. Well, not just the Spire ones. But with this one. I mean this. That's what I mean.
That's what I mean by screwing up my project file. He's ruining my headhunter's square.
Okay. I put it back.
Bye.
I put
Bye
it back.
Head in the square.
I put it back.
I liked you. I really liked you.
Okay, I'm gonna put...
You're in my heart always. Please continue.
I'm selecting pitch A and B right here. Put this down. Put this a bit up, the decay. And then dragging this one down a bit. That would be nice for a screech.
Yeah, if you go up a little bit.
Right, just like this. So a chord would be this. Well, it's clipping right
here. Wait. Do the same chord and increase that that pitch bend slider. The decay. ADSR, the second one. And now do the same chord. Is that 20th Century Fox intro? No, wait. Go up a little bit more. Yeah, try it again.
I know what you mean.
Nice one.
Where were I? Oh, yeah. It was clipping. Now, I think you know I don't like clipping.
D-Tunes doesn't like clipping.
So put this down. Until it doesn't clip. So put this to a new mixer track. Gonna put some simple EQ on it. You know, a low cut to cut off the bass. And just make it a bit more present. But this will be the EQ. A little bit of stereo separation.
Yeah, because that's his invention, of course.
Yeah, I teach him that.
Yeah, D-Tunes invented the stereo separation.
Well, I did not invent it. I just teach it to you.
Yeah, for me you invented it.
True. So, put some reverb on it. Basically kind of the same as the crash.
You could make some presets out of this, simply saving the settings if you use them multiple times, but yeah, it's always fun to change it a little bit.
It's always fun to turn knobs.
Yes, with your mouse.
Now put some compression on it.
Sounds really powerful. Now, how about the Oxford Dynamic? Something I actually paid for. Oh, no, die gaan we. Kut.
Oeps. So, click on in on the compressor. That activates the compressor.
Yeah, it's an old term for putting the cables into the compressor. Yeah, like a plug-in. They used to actually plug in cables into hardware. That's why these digital pieces of software are called plugins. Let's go.
No one cares.
Yeah, some of you do.
Probably not.
Yeah, just say it.
So I'm just going to play a chord. And I'm going to look at this meter on how much the compression is active.
That, I didn't know there was a meter there. Oh, shit.
Okay, so I'm going to play the chord. And I just want the compression to be a bit like right here. So let's go. Like that. Now put the ratio a bit up to make it a bit more
intense.
Thank you. Put the attack a bit down because I don't want that tick at the beginning.
How about using some compression knee? Just try that. Go down a little. Compression E. You can make the picture look more nice, more smooth. Wow! It changed. It makes it somehow more smooth, but I don't know how. Try to use the 5 decibel version. Because now it's better to much. Okay, so let's go to the makeup gain. Because we have decreased volume. And we need to make up for that.
Yes. So, put it up.
Okay, so now let's show us the version without all the effects. That oranje ding.
I know that.
And and the one with the FX. I'm pretty curious about the differences.
So I'm just going to play a C major chord.
Nice.
That's the dry version. Now the wet version.
Now you can hear the sucking effect on the reverb. That's what the compression basically does. So nice. I like it.
I like it too. Thank you. So now let's copy the bass line. Just click this ding. This thing.
Yeah, just click that ding. It's like ding, ding.
Ding-a-ding.
Ding-dong.
Ding-a-ding.
Ooh.
Control-C to copy. Control-V to paste. Let's solo this chord thing.
Yeah, how about chord. Naming your plugins before you throw it into the mixer? Because this is going to be a very long episode 5 for me.
So just solo this by holding control. Now,
I do.
Press this to make it in, to put it in pattern mode. Now, I don't think this is really right, because you have a D here and you have a D here.
Yeah, I knew that is something D-Tune is worried about. I was pretty sure I fixed it, but yeah, I was thinking like, why not? Because you can have high basses and low basses, just like in Colors by Headhunters. The bass goes up with the chords, but in the remakes I usually pulled it down, in the early remakes I did, which was also nice. So it works, so why not? If it sounds nice, why not? But yeah, there's the tunes, of course.
Yeah, here
and he's
am
so
am
correct.
I'm gonna put it down.
Okay, I'm curious how this will sound.
It's not sounding very nice, but that will come.
Yeah, now here's the thing. The melody goes down in the beginning, and now the chords, the bass goes from down to up, and the melody goes from up to down. Will that work? That is the question.
Well, I'm not gonna answer that. Let's make the chords my way right now.
God help
so
me.
So I'm most of the time using a site called skills-chords.com. It's very nice if you want to know the scale of a melody. So we're just going to put in the notes. This is a D sharp, a D. So select a D. A sharp, G, A sharp.
To switch between windows, on windows, use Alt plus Tab. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I think that should be it. Find the scale.
For those who don't have this natural melody thing inside of the heads, it's something I always had. When I make a melody, I just know where to put the right notes, and the notes that don't sound right together, I just know, and I can explain that, but yeah, that's not really normal, I think. So for those who don't really know how to make a melody, this is actually pretty useful.
I'm just going to pick this A sharp major scale. So what I'm going to do, I'm also doing that in my own videos.
It does.
So
I watch them.
So check it out.
Sometimes.
I'm just going to put a note at A sharp, because that's the root note. Now how a major scale works is you skip the next note, you place one on the one after that, you skip a note again.
So there's no sound.
No, there's no sound because we do it in a sampler.
Okay.
And the sampler does not have sound.
So you are basically making those scales or chords, and you're using the ghost helper, the ghost track view note thing, to see your scale in the other layers.
Yeah, just to see what notes would go good with each other.
Yeah.
But keep in mind, this does not always work, because in the new track from Datuikas, The Essence of Eternity, they actually don't use a scale. I searched it up, and there was no existing scale with that melody.
So basically, scales will help you but they are not the only way. Something I know, but D-Tunes
also
took his time to learn that.
But as I was saying, we skip a note, put one on the next one, we skip a note again, put one on the D. Now we don't skip a note, so put one on D sharp.
But that's a black note. So a black note goes with some white notes?
Yeah, depends on what skill you have.
Okay, interesting. I didn't know. Because I was more like thinking white notes, black notes. Yeah. This is not something about racism. This is music. And I was really... because of the black notes really give this... When I make a melody and I want to sound more Arabic, more like a Kashmir melody, I sometimes pull in a black note, but I didn't really knew this was part of a skill. So nice.
Yeah. So we're going to skip a note again. And again. And again. So now we have this. And it will just connect to each other.
I trust you, but how do you know this?
Because I followed some piano lessons. And they explained me how a major scale work.
Also on YouTube?
Yes.
Oh, nice.
So I'm just going to copy this. And I'm going to make it shorter.
This is the one thing that looks pretty creepy in his videos. The very strange looking patterns in the playlist.
Yeah.
Those are the chords.
No, those is that's the scale.
Oh, scale, yeah.
So I'm gonna make chords. So the thing with chords, it's
I'm really creeped out by this. The ghost notes, it's all messed up for me now.
Yeah, not for me. I'm used to it.
Yeah.
I'm just going to make one more.
Now we will find out if my melody fits in these chords or not.
So...
if not, this might explain the essence of life.
The essence of eternity.
Oh, crap. fuck, ik ben gewoon verkeerd. Ga verder.
Okay, so the thing with chords is pretty easy. I'm just going to do this octave out. Skip the next note in the scale. So, wait a second, like that. We're going to skip the next note in the scale. So we're going to skip the D and we're going to place it on D sharp. We're going to skip the F note and we're going to put it on G. So this is the first chord. Just put everything octave up. And that's a good chord, right?
I like it. Okay, but there's a lot of dynamic melody range, a lot of difference between the heights, I think.
Yeah, I'll get to that later.
Okay.
I'm just going to fix the notes first. So this one is probably not going to sound good because you can see in the ghost notes that a note is played on F sharp, which is actually not in the scale. So the melody Fruity Masters use is not in the scale. So the skill does not exist. And this will sound bad.
This?
Well, the chord is okay. But if you put
it... But it's not the right chord for this skill.
Yeah. No, it's the right chord for the skill, but not for the melody. But if you put this with a melody...
Yeah, that F should be an F sharp.
Yeah, if you put it to F sharp...
Hey, I actually said something. That works out.
That sounds way better. We're going to put all the F notes to F sharp. Like that.
Nice.
And the rest of the notes are pretty much in key. So that's really nice. But
they are very inky.
Yeah.
Inky. Inky winky.
But as you said before, there's a lot of range between the notes.
Dynamic range.
So there is one really easy thing I'm going to do. And that's called a chord inversion. I'm just going to select the notes.
Yeah, that's something I know he talked about before. But this will be interesting. I'm pretty sure he's going to press control and arrow down, which he calls the chord inversion. But let's see what happens.
Well, now you said that, I'm not going to do that.
Yep.
So I'm just going to grab the notes, which are, in my opinion, too high. I'm just going to drag them down one octave and not pressing control. So it's basically the same chord, but the notes are
closer to each other.
Yeah.
The chords are closer to each other.
Yeah. So it sounds like this now.
It has, I can feel this one. It's nice.
Yeah.
It sort of gives me some sort of inspiration for the title of this track. Sounds a little bit like, some haunted house or something.
Haunted house.
Yeah, play it again.
It sounds a bit Halloweenish.
Yeah, creepy.
Yeah. So, let's turn the rest on and see what it sounds like without and with. So I'm gonna first play it without. Let's actually put this to pattern one because there's the bass. So now I'm going to turn. Now I'm going to turn it on.
He's going to turn it on. Okay, nice. But we really need to connect those new chords to the pitch bend in the playlist.
Yeah, that's right.
So you know how to do this because I showed you episode 2. Day.
I think I know how to do that.
Okay, let's first increase the pitch bend range to 12 because I really like a very hard pitch bend on chords. Yeah.
Yeah, so we're gonna click browse parameters. I'm just
parameters.
Wobble this thing because if you,
yeah, when you turn a knob, you will the knob you just turned will light up in the parameter list.
Yeah, so if you want to do a cutoff automation, just wobble the cutoff and
there it is.
But we do want the pitch bend, so we wobble the pitch bend and it's right here. So click to link to controller. We're going to click the XI control X.
Yes,
and then just click accept.
X always works, except for the iPhone.
What?
The iPhone X.
Yeah, precies.
This is a flop.
So, does it work now?
Let's try.
One thing I...
precies was in the...
Oh, you already did that. You already locked it.
Yes, something I learned from the tunes. He really loves me to say this.
Okay, so let's see what it sounds like.
Try linking it again, because if it's already linked, it will show up.
I think I did it wrong. Well, I'm pretty sure I did it wrong because it doesn't work. But I have to put it to the automation clip.
No.
Yes.
No. Oh, wait, was put to the I. You are need to put it to the X.
No.
Trust me, I swear.
No.
Really? Nee, echt waar.
Nee, echt. Wedden? You want to bet on it?
You want to bet on it?
Yeah.
How much? What? Beer. Lots of beer. Hertog Jan. En krap.
Heineken.
Zuip hem samen op.
We shall see.
So, if he's wrong, he's going to buy a krat of beer. For me.
A krat of beer.
Okay, try it out. Just do it.
Okay.
I'm Fruity Masters. Oh, damn. Hey, wait. That's really weird. How can this happen?
Wait.
Perhaps this Fruity Masters guy was right.
Yeah.
How about unlocking it and locking it to the X? Because now you need to change the link.
To?
X. And accept. Now try it again. Hey, no, wait, that's really funny because now it does work. So that's some
really
free beer for me.
I really want to know what I did wrong because I think I exactly did this.
Now, do you want to know why the chord suddenly appeared to be one octave higher?
I do know.
You do know?
I do know.
Because of the XI controller, which yes. has been set on a maximum pitch bend range of 50%, which is basically the zero in silent, which doesn't allow it to go higher.
Let me explain it easier.
Okay.
You have an automation clip. If it is put in the middle, the line, you know, if the line is in the middle,
yeah.
it's 50%. This one is in the middle. This knob is in the middle, so it's 50%. This automation clip right here is not 50%, because it's all the way at the top. So, what this knob will do, it's going to put it all the way at the top.
Yes.
Yes.
And that's why the XI controller is very nice, because you can set a limit. So, the pitch bend doesn't go up, and you don't... you can create real easy automation clips on the pitch bend by going all the way up and not having to think about this... middle or 50% thing.
So, let's hear what it sounds like all together.
I'm damn curious.
Me too. I immediately think the crash is way too loud.
It's pretty present.
Yeah, so let's put it down. Also, the sweep downs are a bit too high, in my opinion. What do you think?
I like it. Can you play it again from the beginning?
Yeah, sure.
I need to focus a little bit more. I think this is a really good beginning. We are going. We are starting to get there. It sounds nice. When you look at the playlist, we didn't really change a lot. But when you hear the melody right now and the kick, it really changed a lot. It sounds a little bit bigger.
Yeah. Yeah. So we can kind of compare it to what it was before. So we're going to disable this ones, these ones, and we're going to disable the,
yes.
we're going to disable the chords. So this was it before. Now enable everything again, and this is it now.
I like it. It's nice. So this might be a good wrap-up of the episode of the video.
Okay.
So everyone, thank you all for watching. This is the end result of episode 4. I personally think it sounds nice. D-Tunes likes it too, I think.
Yeah.
So this was really interesting. And perhaps he will be back next episode.
But or after maybe
that,
not.
Yeah, maybe not. We don't know. You might never know. No, you will know.
Because,
sure.
well, if you're dead, they won't know. Because yeah, you won't upload then.
Yeah, that's true. If I get hit by a bus tomorrow, which is very likely in the Netherlands, I might survive, but I might not be able to upload this episode. But it was really fun to make it.
Yeah.
So, yeah. See you again soon or something like it. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Awesome.